all over the arena. They are standing. Same two men for what might be the draw of the year. To either extend the game, or in the case of Pittsburgh, to end it and win a Stanley Cup. Cullen and Fisher. Off the tie-up. It is brushed on back, kept by Subban. Close quarters, now it's Forsberg. Dealt back up by Cullen, pitched back by Forsberg and Arvidsson. Got it around behind a Neal. Step to the front, couldn't get a good shot away. Loose puck is picked up now by Hornqvist and dealt back out. Along the turn is Subban, 28 seconds to go. Able to move away from Kunitz. Subban able to get it one side, back to Arvidsson. Arvidsson tried to play it to the front, Dumoulin got there. Forced back off the boards, and Subban can't catch up to it. Along comes Hagelin, moving on in. He scores! Hagelin with 13.6 to go, and the Penguins celebrate at the bench. They almost clocked their coach, Mike Sullivan, with the stray sticks. And debris comes down on the ice.
Please do not throw anything on the ice. Please.
Two to nothing in favor of the Penguins. On the goal by Carl Hagelin. And the Penguins celebrate what will be the first back-to-back Stanley Cup championships in the salary cap era. The owner and rescuer of the franchise, the coaching staff, celebrating the empty net goal by Carl Hagelin. It was a month before the end of the season when the man games missed to injury were at the highest and the team play wasn't the best that Mike Sullivan met with his players and asked them to come up with phrases to describe what they needed to do to win again. They came up with four: discipline, chip bodies, meaning make sure you get a physical piece of the opponent, compete level, and puck management. And those were the foundation of the Stanley Cup on this t-shirt with all the names of the current players and the support players from Wilkes-Barre Scranton. And they continue to jump up and down at the Penguins bench. And the party that went on inside their arena back home and out where their arena was once located will continue into the night. And they will await yet another parade, the fifth one since 1991. The final seconds go off, and now the fans here salute their team with Let's Go Predators. A turnaround shot that rattled wide. Subban one more try, deflected over the net, and the Pittsburgh Penguins again are the Stanley Cup champions. Celebrate a remarkable year here in Nashville and for their players and fans. Sidney Crosby led his team and is one of the leading candidates for the Conn Smythe, which will be presented before the Stanley Cup. But they all gather around to celebrate the coaches, both American-born, for the first time in Stanley Cup history, congratulate one another. And the chant here is Let's Go Preds.
What happened?
The Predators wait patiently. The motto here was stand with us, and these people did stand with their team. All games this season, for the first time in the 19-year history, were sold out. And now they wait for the handshake line to form. Usually it is the captains who are at the forefront of this. And eventually it will begin. The first handshakes begin in hockey in 1904. That was long before the National Hockey League ever came into existence, and long before they took possession of the Stanley Cup, part of an old Canadian tradition. And now they peel away from the celebration for congratulations to each other. And leading the way is Brian Dumoulin for the Penguins and PK Subban for the Predators. And with all that happened during the course of this, PK Subban is coming very close to Sidney Crosby. And so we will watch with interest. Some slaps on the shoulders, and they move on. Chris Letang got into his uniform, not able to play during these playoffs and not until next fall, but there to join his team.
You win, Doc. You have a lot of adversity. The Penguins win without their best defenseman and all the injuries that they had. And all teams have injuries over the course of 7-8 weeks. Nick Bonino can barely stand up, and he's out there in a celebration. But back-to-back, all the different line combinations for Mike Sullivan this year compared to last year. How about the job by Marc-Andre Fleury in these playoffs? The game seven against Washington, a shutout after struggling in back-to-back games in 5 and 6. You need everybody. You never know when your number is going to be called. Just an amazing run for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
The goaltenders meet. I thought we'd probably still be playing as expertly as these two guys played in this game tonight, and particularly on their home ice. The Conn Smythe Trophy is presented to the player judged to be the most valuable player in the playoffs.